Ready or not, once sperm and egg get together, they have their own agenda: to create a viable embryo. Their chances aren't great. It's estimated that more than 50% of all fertilized eggs fail to develop. If it's going to survive, the egg has a lot of work to do. First, it orders the zona to lock out all other sperm. And then the egg must finish meiosis, expelling half of its chromosomes into this tiny pouch called a polar body. With the door closed behind it, the single sperm already inside releases its precious cargo. The sperm's 23 chromosomes stretch out in the roomy, welcoming egg. The chromosomes of sperm and egg approach each other, and then the cell divides. Since the moment the sperm entered the egg, 24 hours have passed. All this time, the fertilized egg is moving down the fallopian tube toward the uterus. Every few hours, the cells divide. 4, 8, 16. Gradually creating the building blocks needed to construct an embryo. On rare occasions, the tiny cluster of cells splits into two groups and creates two embryos, identical twins. But most of the time, the cells stick together. They must complete just the right number of cell divisions before they arrive in the uterus about 5 days after fertilization. What started as a large single cell has divided into just over 100 much smaller cells. But they're still trapped within the hard shell of the zona. Now called a blastocyst, the bundle of cells must do two things to survive: break out of the zona, and find a source of nourishment. At the beginning of the sixth day, it orchestrates an escape. It releases an enzyme that eats through the zona, and the ball of cells squeezes out. Free at last, the blastocyst lands on the blood-rich lining of the mother's uterus. It has just passed one hurdle, but is immediately presented with another. For in fact, it is now in very grave danger. Stripped of its protective coating, the blastocyst could be attacked by the mother's immune system as a foreign invader. White blood cells would swarm in to devour it. In its own self-defense, the ball of cells produces several chemicals that suppress the mother's immune system inside the uterus, in effect convincing the mother to treat it like a welcome guest. Then it is free to get to work. Searching for food and oxygen, cells from the blastocyst reach down and burrow into the surrounding tissue. Eventually, they pull the entire bundle down into the uterine lining. And sooner or later, the mother will notice.
Even brushing my teeth would make me, the minty flavor was just like gross and make me feel nauseous. And I would get up and I would try to eat something, and if anything smelled off slightly, then it made me nauseous.
My mother has told me stories of how my father had gone through morning sickness, and of course, that never really registered until the first time it started happening to me.
He would get really, really nauseous and upset and actually get physically ill sometimes. I mean,
there was more than a couple of times when that actually happened.
Not everybody gets morning sickness. Sometimes months can go by before the mother gets any sense of the drama unfolding within her body.